T-Mobile's getting their third taste of Samsung's TouchWiz user interface. They previously had it in the form of the Samsung Behold and also the Memoir. Both actually featured some impressive camera specs. But now we have the Samsung Highlight, which takes everything that we love from the Samsung's TouchWiz user interface and has it in a more slimmer, compact form. Samsung doesn't stray far from the traditional slate form factor that they use on the Samsung Highlight. It's actually similar in dimensions with the Behold and Memoir that followed before it. Now they use this blue plastic, which of course feels very plasticky, but at the same time a little bit more harder and more durable than most of the others that compare to it. The back has this pattern design just to give it a different look. Other than that, it's relatively pocketable when you place it in your pockets, and it won't put too much thickness to it. Luckily though, it also feels a little bit heavier just because of the battery that's inside of it. Now the first thing you'll notice is the beautiful 3-inch LCD screen. It may not be as bright or luminous as something like an Active Matrix OLED found on the Impression on AT&T, but luckily it does get the job done. It's pretty bright. You'll be able to read pretty much anything on text on screen just because of its great resolution, and it's pretty responsive, so we definitely like the screen. You have also on the front your send and end keys, and back a clear key, which has pretty good, you know, tactile feel and well sized for anyone. On the left you have the dedicated volume rocker. On the other side, dedicated camera button, lock on lock, and also your proprietary charging port. And on the back you have your 3-megapixel camera with the speakerphone. No flash or self portrait mirror though. And when you remove the battery, the back cover, it reveals the battery, the SIM card slot, and also the micro SD card slot, which is just kind of a pain having to get access to because you have to remove the battery physically. The one thing we were disappointed in is actually we're treated with the same exact TouchWiz user interface found on the Behold and also Memoir. Of course, on the left you have your widgets, which you could place onto the home screen to give it a good personalized look. So as far as personalization goes, it's a wonderful interface for that. Unfortunately though, the widgets are pretty much the same exact ones that we've seen previously. None of them are really eye-opening or, you know, really worthy enough to be something new. The other thing that we notice is just that this version on this device just runs a little bit slower than the other models, especially when you notice the transition effects. There's just some sort of lag. Other than that, navigating is pretty simple with the menu keys, and they just break it down to simple large icons that are touch friendly. Of course, this is going to be geared towards text messengers out there, so sending text messages is a breeze. There's many ways you could go about doing that. You could use the traditional touch keypad. It's quite responsive, and there's also vibration feedback whenever you do use it. You could even use the handwriting recognition, which we did find to be not that as accurate as we liked. And of course, the best form is using the full QWERTY keyboard type. It's probably by far the best and easiest way to go about doing that. The other thing is the instant messaging application that it uses. It's powered by iOS, and of course you have your AIM, Windows Live, and also Yahoo to choose from. As far as the email program goes though, it doesn't have a full support for, you know, specific mail clients. It only gives you a listing, and of course if yours is not on there, unfortunately you won't be able to use it directly. You have to actually load up the browser and go through that way. The web browser is actually the same that we've seen from, again, the previous devices. It's tolerable, to say the least. At least a load of complex websites like ours. On top of that, scrolling isn't as bad. Of course, it's not as fluid or as smooth as we liked, but does get the job done. It doesn't have also a page overview, which would come in handy. But luckily, the zooming out, and zooming in function is pretty relatively quick. At least it resizes the site fast enough for you to actually start scrolling again. So as we said, it's tolerable, not the best out there, but it's decent. We had a poor performance with phone call quality on the Highlight. That's just because voices sounded muffled when we were speaking on there and hearing our callers. And there's also this staticky background noise at all times, even when there's dead silence, it was very pronounced. The speakerphone quality wasn't as strong as we would like it to. It was on the weaker side. Granted that it didn't crackle when we placed in the high setting, but we just had a hard time hearing our callers. The great thing about the Highlight is the 8 days of battery life we got out of it using it on normal use. It's pretty impressive. That's partly because of the larger size battery that they use over what's found on the Behold or even Memoir. The 3-megapixel camera does take some decent shots, not the most detailed, but it's good enough for a 4x6 printout. And of course, if you're going to be using it for media features, playing videos and also music, it was a decent experience. Videos, there was no slowdown, no hiccups. And on top of that, music, it did a good job. No slowdown, as we said, and it also plays the mini player on the desk, on the home screen, if you exit back out. The Samsung highlight just stays stagnant, and we were just hoping to see Samsung come out with a really new device with innovative features and also just either an update to the TouchWiz interface. But basically what we got here is the same device we've seen already on T-Mobile's lineup, except that it has some reduced specs, a little bit slower with the TouchWiz interface. Granted that it does have better battery life, but other than that, we were just unimpressed with the overall design and performance of it.